next question is, can I take readable version and process it to make to see the raw version? Now, yeah, you can. So I'll give a small example of how you could go about that. So let's just make my test again. CD my test. Let's assume you want to see some content of some readable policy. So let's just create a module, my test TE, and declare a policy module. That's something that you also always need to do, and then we'll do this in raw in a readable policy way, of course, because that's what we're trying to do. My test 1.0. And so now let's say you want to see what the files read, etc files readable policy allows. So then you can basically call that files read etc files, but you'll need to call it for some domain, and that's, we'll just use type httpdt. It expects a single parameter, which is a domain, so we can basically require that and use that just for purposes of testing. Can we acquire, so we importing that, this is the readable way of importing an external type, and then just call that for httpdt. And so this is the readable way to do that. Now let's just make that, make f user share as Linux dval, make file, and then my test pp. Okay, so now you have yourself a pp file. So now you can actually use some nifty commands to translate that stuff. So there's this man se module unpackage, and it's already unpackaged, but there's already an unpackaged version there, but I'll just show you anyway. So here you have an example of how you can use that. So copy this and then ls, and then basically paste this in, paste, and then my change that to my test my test, and then this will create a mod file in here. So we have a mod file in there, and then you can use the se module or se this mod command, and then with my test mod, I think. And now you can actually see inside of this. So you can basically set an output file here, f file name output text, and m for menu again, and then you can basically display stuff that is in this module. So let's just say we want to see the unconditional AV table, so one. And we want to see the conditionals, and we want to see the users, bools, roles, types, attributes, aliases, seven transitions, if there's any, eight also, policy con, initial sets, the whole damn thing, B, C, and now of course these ABCs you probably could avoid. But anyway, so now you have this output text, get that or nano that or less it. And this basically outputs everything. Now, basically this is because I know it, but this is basically what that single, that files read etc files actually allows. this is basically what it allows, unconditional. So if you add the files read etc files, then you allow HTTPD to IO control read get attribute log search and open etc type dirs. You allow it to get attribute search and open etc type dirs. You allow it to IO control read get attribute log open etc t files and stuff like that, and all this other stuff. And then these others, I just added that, that these are the conditions. So here you basically have where the section stops. So this was 1, this was 2, this 3, 4, 5, until 7, and then there's the ABC, which basically don't really apply. But anyways, this is basically what the files read etc files allows, and this stuff doesn't really apply. This gives all the security classes and their permissions, I guess. Yep. And here it adds some roles and some types that it includes. So yeah, this is basically how you can check that out. So you could, unfortunately, you can't use this non-interactively, else you could simply script this. But I think this is only used interactively. So if you want to know a rule, then just add a rule in the policy module, and then just basically unpackage that module and then use that mod file to look inside that mod file, and then you'll see the raw rules. It's not in the in the way you expect it. So you'll see brackets here, which you normally wouldn't see, but these are the raw rules actually, so it's actually translating it for you.